for tuning back into Boss Lady News. We've got a busy, busy show today. I want you to go ahead and put your hands together for Ivania Nicole and the title holders for Miss Central Massachusetts. How are you?
Hi, Lenny. How are
you? Thank you for coming on again.
Always a pleasure.
Ladies, please feel free. Have a seat. I'm so glad you were able to come on. I know you guys have been busy, busy, busy. I've been seeing all of the stuff that's going on social media. First and foremost, this is Ivania.
Hi.
Eva is in charge of directing, coordinating, created Miss Central Massachusetts. Mm-hmm. And you've been doing this now for how long?
This was my fifth year.
Fifth year. How excited are you about that?
It is exciting. You just don't really plan it. It just happens.
It just comes together.
It's getting bigger.
It comes together very well. I was there, had an opportunity to host, which thank you.
Yes.
Thank you very much. It was very exciting seeing all of you young ladies up there and so prepared and ready to compete. So why don't you introduce yourselves first, Miss Central Massachusetts.
My name is Roxanne Riba Gonzalez, and I'm Miss Central Massachusetts.
And Miss Teen Central Massachusetts.
My name is Jessica Reyes, and I'm Miss Teen Central Massachusetts.
So tell me first a little bit about yourselves individually.
I've been competing in pageants since I was 13 years old, so about like 9 years now. This will be my first biggest competition, I guess you could say, preparing for. And
wow.
I'm really excited to be able to represent our community local-wise and Latina-wise.
Yeah. You said 9 years.
Yes.
What made you decide to even want to start doing pageants?
When I was younger, I was really shy. Mm-hmm. Like, I didn't even speak to anyone. And my mom thought that by putting me in pageants would be a good idea to kind of break out of my shell and go into a field where I'd be able to be more comfortable with speaking to other people. Mm-hmm. And I started when I was 13 and didn't stop.
So I know we're technically not supposed to ask people their ages, but you guys are young enough to ask that age. How old are you?
I just turned 21.
Congratulations. Thank you. Congratulations on the title also.
Thank you.
Miss Teen, how can you describe the opportunity to really be able to compete for it, for the crown?
Well, the opportunity, I give a lot of thanks to Eva for, you know, allowing me to participate in her pageant, knowing it was my very first.
Mm-hmm.
It was nice because I got to meet a lot of people, and it was just a great experience for me because it was my first pageant, not knowing what I was going into, so.
Yeah. Were you nervous? Because I saw you in the beautiful orange dress at the
Thank
end.
Thank you.
And you had so much confidence. Yeah. Where did all of that come from?
I was nervous, but as I was going up on the stage, I just like cleared my mind and I was like, you know what, I really want this. So if I show the judges that I'm confident enough, I think I could win.
Yeah.
So.
And you won.
Yeah.
What was your favorite out of the pageant?
I would have to say the opening number, mostly because I didn't really know what I was doing. I learned to dance probably 10 minutes before the pageant.
Okay.
That was my fault. But, it gave us the opportunity to kind of express who we truly are, and before the judges even really got to know us on stage. And it gave us a chance to kind of show the audience as well that we're here because we like what we're doing, we're having fun, and it's not just a competition. It's a way for us to get to know other people, too.
Yeah. And what was your favorite?
My favorite part, I would say, would be the interview with the judges because I got to know the judges one-on-one. They each got to see my personality and the reason why I think I should win. So I really liked the interview.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And the interviews, Ivania, they were done not around the parents.
No, the parents are not allowed. And basically, it's kind of like a round robin. So mm-hmm. Each girl sits down and has like a one-on-one with the judge.
Mm-hmm.
And the judge have, when they actually sign up, they have a resume, an application of judges that they fill out. So they actually sell themselves through that piece of paper. So when they sit down with the judge actually reads a little bit and actually knows what kind of questions to ask them.
Mm-hmm.
So, they pick out some really good girls, so
mm-hmm.
I mean it's like such a like really like I don't know how they actually pick it, but I'm just saying like a lot of these girls have such great success stories, and not only that, they're so accomplished at their age, And it's just, it's really good just to like know that you're like offering these girls an opportunity. Mm-hmm. Some of these girls come like her, it's her first pageant. Roxanne, she's like a rock star. So she's been doing this forever, and I've been telling her to come sign up, sign up, sign up. And you know, it's like every year it's like different, and it's like, it's really bittersweet for me because like I do all the recruiting. Mm-hmm. So, and then it's like kind of sad because then, you know, some girls like they don't win it, and you know, it's like you have to kind of be there and support them and just be like, you gotta keep going. It's not about all about winning, but
so also. So once there are determined title holders, the young ladies that participated in it before, do they get an opportunity to try again?
Oh yeah, they can always come back again if they want to, of course. The only thing about teens and miss, if they age out. Mm-hmm. So if they're over 27, they can't compete because these girls right now, they're actually getting ready for Miss Massachusetts USA.
Yes.
In November, and she's training with Katie Boyd, who is like the guru of fitness. Katie Boyd, Miss Fit Club. Shout out to her. And Jessica, she'll be starting soon. And you know, it's intense.
How excited are you guys to be like in the running for Miss Massachusetts?
For me, it's honestly a dream come true. I mean, ever since I started competing, I've always wanted to compete in Miss Mass USA, just never really had the courage or like the confidence to do so. So competing in Miss Central Mass kind of gave me the boost to really believe in myself and see that I'm really capable of showing everyone that I'm willing and have the qualities to be a great title holder.
Okay, Jessica?
I get very nervous as the days go. Like, it's like November's right around the corner. Mm-hmm. So I'm just like getting prepared, my platform, just like getting sponsors, you know, like I'm really nervous, but I'm working very hard so they can see my, you know, how far I got.
Yes. So. Outside of the pageantry, what do you guys see yourselves doing?
I see myself doing things in the communications field. My father lives in Puerto Rico and he kind of raised me to love the radio, love TV, and love mm-hmm. everything that has to do with being in the public eye. So I want to follow his footsteps and make him proud.
Okay, that sounds awesome. I love communications. And what about you, Jessica?
I see myself being a makeup artist mm-hmm. soon, like later on in the years, because right now I'm in cosmetology school.
And I can tell, your eyes are beautiful.
Thank you. And I'm working very hard in school because I want to be very successful. So I want to become a makeup artist or a hairstylist. So.
Wow. And we've only got 1 minute left. We're going to bring out the other young ladies.
Yes.
And those two are?
Miss Princess and Little Miss.
Miss Princess and Little Miss. Mm-hmm. And I want to thank you ladies for coming out. And hopefully we'll get a chance to have you come back on and see how everything went in November.
Yeah.
Sounds good?
Yep.
Okay.
I hope you're going to come.
Oh, of course. I'll be there.
I'll have your poster up.
We're going to cut to a brief PSA, and when we come back, you guys are going to get a chance to meet the young ladies that were competing for the title also. Now to KTC, many stop from A to Z. Jeremy Scott, G Von Sheep. Bet you ain't got shit on me. Chrome hearts, Fendi furs, tripped and shit you never heard. Ride, 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 riding down so steady. Black on black Lamborghini. Haters can't never see me. Come and get me too slow. I'm about that paper chasing. Body by face amazing. Burn, burn, keeps it blazing. Too hot to handle, can't touch this. You think you better, but you can't hit it.
This is the moment I knew. His future had no boundaries.
There are some moments only the forest can inspire. Find yours at discovertheforest.org.
I'm very excited. You guys are watching Boss Lady News. It's a busy, busy show today. It's a live show. You guys, I guess you could call in, but please feel free to hit me up on any of my social media. Let's meet the little people that were competing for these titles. Ladies, you want to come on out here? This is Miss Princess and Little Miss Central Massachusetts. How are you guys doing today?
Good.
Oh, you're so pretty. You guys were so cute when I got a chance to see you competing on stage.
Thank you.
Please introduce yourselves to my audience, Miss Princess.
Angelina Lee Fisher, Miss Princess Central Mass.
Okay.
My name is Madeline Barcenas. I am 12 years old and I am Little Miss Central Massachusetts.
Still getting used to it, huh? Now, how much do you love the tiaras first?
I adore them. It makes me feel like an actual queen and like represents that I stayed strong and competed, tried my best, pushed myself to win.
And you did it.
Mm-hmm.
And what about you?
I know I was gonna win, so I just crossed my fingers.
Mm-hmm.
And then I just heard called my name, and then I walk up the stage, and then I took pictures, and I forgot to walk again.
That's
okay.
And Eva, you've been getting all of the title holders into a variety of different opportunities so that they can do some volunteer work and kind of get their names out there. How is that going?
Oh, they love it. They love it. They do. And basically, we kind of like look into the activities. But if anybody out there that's listening or watching, if you guys ever want to have our girls participate in the event or, you know, host or something like that, we would definitely be, you know, all for it. I mean, we're going to be doing the fashion show Saturday.
Yes, you young ladies are going to be rocking the runway for me. I'm excited about that. Mm-hmm.
So, you know, and as opportunities come, we take them because it's exposure for them and it's exposure for the organization. And, you know, I want all the girls to know that you don't really need to have experience. There's no height or weight requirement. And, you know, everyone is beautiful.
Yes. Now, when you guys had your opportunities to kind of compete, what was your favorite part about it?
My favorite part was meeting new people, creating new friends. That is actually a very hard thing for me sometimes because I'm very hyper most of the time, but creating new friends during the pageant made me feel good, made me feel like I was like it was a pageant family.
Oh, I like how you said that. Because normally people think about pageants and pageant moms, and it's so much of a competition that maybe the young ladies aren't enjoying it. What was your favorite part?
My favorite part was winning the crown, and I heard called my name.
Yeah.
And I love that part.
Yeah. You just felt like you were the only person in the room.
Yeah.
Well, she actually has a comment. You remember how we brought Miss Princess? That's actually her cousin.
Oh,
so
wow.
Victoria and Angelina are cousins, so it runs in their family, I guess.
Okay.
They just have those pageant genes.
Mm-hmm. Did you guys, as of yet, start thinking about what you might want to do in the future when you get a little bit older?
I'm actually going to continue my career of doing pageants. I plan to continue it. Winning or no winning, I'll still be proud of myself because I try my best. And also, becoming a teacher would be nice because I adore little children.
Aww. That's awesome. Like I said, we've had nothing but teachers and teachers in the making on Boss Lady News today. And what about you? Have you had any thoughts about what you might want to do in the future?
Well, I adore babies because they're so cute.
Mm-hmm.
And I love them because I get to hold them.
Yeah.
I have one baby cousin.
Aww.
Tiny.
So you want to work with the babies when you get older?
Yeah.
Maybe a doctor in pediatrics? I like that idea. Sounds good. Now, in November, the older title holders, Miss Central Massachusetts and Little Miss Central Massachusetts.
No, Miss and Miss Teen.
And Miss Teen. They're going to be competing. Now, what will these young ladies be looking forward to?
Actually, they just, we don't have anything for them to move forward to.
Okay.
You know, there's just not that type of outlet here. But what I do provide is modeling classes with Karen Shea.
Okay.
And building up their portfolio. And as well as their, you know, coordination for the year. Mm-hmm. And after they'll be done, they'll be signed to a modeling agency.
Awesome.
As like the other ones in the past.
Awesome.
So that's what we do. We kind of just build them up. And, you know, they're so little too. So there's really not much that you could do. I wish.
Yeah.
But
maybe some more volunteer stuff until the following year.
Yeah, absolutely.
So this is an official request out there, people. We've got some title holders. I want a crown. That's my problem. That's why I'm stuttering. But we've got some title holders here that are looking for some volunteer work, and give them an opportunity to really show what they're able to do, and give them an opportunity to teach other young ladies, you know, everything that you guys had to go through, but also building that kind of like family base and friendships and the bonds that happen between it all.
Yeah, so don't believe any of that pageant stigma. It's actually awesome, and we work very hard to build these girls' self-esteem, and they will carry these gems throughout their career life and older. And I mean, yeah. I've always wanted a crown, so I couldn't get one, so I just made one.
There you go. Well, I want to thank you for coming on to Boss Lady News, and we're going to follow up with you, and trust me, we'll have some things for you to do, okay?